The first thing I heard was Kangana ma'am's doing it, and I was like, okay, I love her.
And we of course have to talk about Prassthanam, your upcoming project.
We do. So her name is Shivi. She's actually an NRI.
Hi Amyra.
Hi.
Welcome to Box Office India.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. You have a lovely house, I must say.
Thank you. It's very Parsi.
Yeah, it is. And the best thing is, I think it faces the sea.
I'm somebody who needs to see the water as much as possible.
Are you a water baby?
Totally. If you ask me like where I feel at peace, it's on the beach.
That's great. We all love beaches.
Thank you.
So Amyra, I was reading an interview of yours. You said that it's tough being an outsider in the industry. You had to go through 30 rounds of auditions before you became part of ISAC, right?
Yes.
So you have almost done 10 films now. So does the hard work seem worth it?
It definitely does. I mean, it's reached a point where after every new film, there are so many changes in people's attitude towards me.
Yeah.
In people even opening up to me more, as in calling me in for more auditions or more brands. And I think it's a beautiful process, because at the end of the day, being somebody who's coming from the outside, and I feel like it's just getting better and better, and it's more worth it.
Yeah.
You know, all the struggle, all the hard work, I'm feeling good about it.
So Amyra, what is the benchmark of success for you?
Honestly, to be constantly working, and I think that is what's happening. I don't have like a goal, or I don't see 100 crores as a benchmark at this point, because I do believe that a lot of figures are inflated.
Yeah.
And see. But at the end of the day, for me, I just, as long as I'm constantly working, as long as the quality of work I'm getting is what it is, I'm happy.
Right. And we of course have to talk about Judgemental Hai Kya, which released some time back. Mm-hmm. And we love the film. Trust me, it's my favorite film of the year so
far.
Thank
you. I'm so glad you said that. Isn't it trippy? It's so
trippy. Oh my
God,
it is. It's a great film. I wanted to watch it again, but then I couldn't. But I'll watch it soon. So tell me, you know, on the face value, it was Rajkummar and Kangana's film.
Yes, it was.
What really drew you to the subject?
I think when the first thing I heard was Kangana ma'am's doing it, and I was like, okay, I love her. I've said this in my interviews before as well. She's somebody who I've always been inspired by, whose choreograph is something I want to achieve. You know, so that was a huge point for me to even like consider doing a film like this.
Yeah.
And then I went and auditioned, and I met Prakash, our director, and he narrated the entire story to me, and I fell in love with it. I fell in love with the story itself, because I feel like in India we don't talk about mental illness.
Yeah.
We look at it as a taboo.
Right.
We don't respect people who have it, and I feel like these are the kind of films I want to do, where we open society's eyes in a way, and we're like, listen, it's not a bad thing.
Right.
Everything is like, you know, just because it's looked at so badly, it doesn't mean it's a bad thing. Because ultimately, when you see the film, you realize it's not the person who's mentally sick that's the bad person.
Mm-hmm.
It's the person who's a psycho that's the bad person.
Right. And the people who judge, they are the bad people.
The people who judge.
Right. So you have done films irrespective of whether you were the female lead or the parallel lead.
Yeah.
So how important is screen time for you?
I feel the time of this whole star culture concept is sort of going down. It's about scripts, it's about characters, it's about making an impact.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, I feel you can make an impact even while playing a character.
Yeah.
You know, because, and so many people have come to me, even though a film like Judgemental had a Rajkummar and a Kangana, people have come up to me saying, dude, you were so good also.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's something that makes a big difference, because, I mean, to be noticed next to two power-packed, amazing performers is sort of a prize itself, you know.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, I don't, as long as the part is good and impactful, it doesn't matter whether it's a second lead or a lead for me.
Right. And we of course have to talk about Prassthanam, your upcoming project.
We do.
You're the truth seeker, that's what the poster says, right? So what can you tell us about your character?
So her name is Shivi. She's actually an NRI, and she's from a university in America, and she's come to do a lot of research and write a proper thesis about politics in India.
Wow.
Yeah. So through this process, she comes across this family as she meets Ali, because it's his entire family that's in this Lucknowi politics. You know, we've got Sanju Baba playing his father and Jackie Sir playing his guard, his, you know, right hand man. So when she sort of sees this world that she's never seen before, she starts realizing there's a lot of like shady business, a lot of, you know, corruption that's going on, and essentially a lot of people are also dying around her.
Right.
So she's trying to find out why it's so bad, who is actually behind the killings, who is behind the violence, you know, because India to her is her jaan.
Right.
It's a beautiful country. She is Indian, she's just lived abroad. So for her, it's that character that sort of wants to see the right in this country come out. Mm-hmm. And she tries to go after the bad. So you have to see what happens when she does.
You're really excited.
Hi everyone, I'm Amyra Dastur and you're watching me on Box Office India. Please like, share and subscribe. Jackie, so if you ever hear him talk or if you ever hear him speak, he just talks to everyone the same way. Like everyone's his guru. I would just stare at Manisha ma'am on set because she's
so beautiful.
Like, her skin just glows.